Trump sets secret trap to catch Obama 24 hours after rogue UN official exposes active coup at WH. Obama has had an extremely difficult time relinquishing the power he was held as president of the untied states, as he's spent every waking moment in recent months obsessing on ways to take out President Trump as he operates his shadow government from the headquarters of his D.C. mansion just 3 miles from the White House. Over the past couple of weeks, Obama toured Asia, where he's been going around bashing President Trump's policies to leaders across the globe, where he was first suspiciously spotted with President Xi Jinping of China following Trump's successful visit just a few short weeks ago, telling leaders in China, France and India that the United States is suffering from a temporary absence of American leadership. Ever since Trump took office, Barack Hussein Obama has been doing everything in his power to take our new president out. Trump has constantly been plagued with leaks coming from spies that Obama has implanted throughout the White House, where our top intelligence keeps winding up in the hands of the liberal media. In addition to constant leaks, we learned earlier this week from a rogue United Nations official that Obama is actively engaging in a coup d'état against President Trump, which is the first time this has happened to a sitting president in our nation's history. As Obama continues to break federal law as a civilian by meeting with foreign diplomats to plot for Trump's removal, President Trump is now making an unprecedented move to make Obama and his minions pay for their crimes once and for all. Obama has had an extremely difficult time relinquishing the power he was held as president of the untied states, as he's spent every waking moment in recent months obsessing on ways to take out President Trump as he operates his shadow government from the headquarters of his D.C. mansion just 3 miles from the White House. Over the past couple of weeks, Obama toured Asia, where he's been going around bashing President Trump's policies to leaders across the globe, where he was first suspiciously spotted with President Xi Jinping of China following Trump's successful visit just a few short weeks ago, telling leaders in China, France and India that the United States is suffering from a temporary absence of American leadership. Working with foreign governments to overthrow the president of the untied states as Obama is actively doing is a serious federal crime as spelled out in 18 U.S. Code 2385 that could land him 20 years in behind bars, but Obama doesn't seem to care. He's still actively implanting his spies all throughout Washington, D.C., where we learned this week that President Trump's inner circle has yet again been infiltrated by an Obama operative. Trump just learned through a CIA official that his very own national security advisor, General H.R. McMaster, has been working for Obama for months and had set up surveillance on not on President Trump, but his entire family. This latest scandal that's ripping through Washington, D.C. was unearthed by CIA officer John R. McGuire, who revealed during a recent intelligence gathering operation that McMaster was the individual this entire time authorizing illegal surveillance on President Trump, including Trump's entire family and also Steve Bannon. McGuire also stated that McMaster was one of the members of Obama's inner circle for 8 years, saying that the military general has been using a burner phone to send information of his unlawful surveillance to an outside source. What's even more chilling is that this intelligence that was gathered by McMaster was then sent straight to a surveillance facility in Cyprus that is owned by George Soros. McGuire told at least two people that National Security Advisor H.R. McMaster, in coordination with a top official at the National Security Agency, authorized surveillance of Stephen Bannon and Trump family members, including Donald Trump Jr. and Eric Trump. Adding to these unsubstantiated claims, McGuire told the potential donors he also had evidence H.R. McMaster used a burner phone to send information gathered through the surveillance to a facility in Cyprus owned by George Soros. This latest scandal comes right on the heels of rogue United Nations official John Bolton breaking rank earlier this week, revealing there's something much more sinister at play with Obama's recent world tours, and that the former president is actively trying to overthrow Trump's administration, while not hesitating to break federal law to get the job done. Bolton stated that Obama is actively staging a coup d'état, which is the first time such a thing has ever happened to a sitting president. The Gateway Pundit reported. Lou Dobbs and Ambassador Bolton discussed the latest developments in the Mueller witch hunt and Barack Obama's latest tour across Asia to attack sitting President Trump. This is the first coup d'etat in American history, Bolton stated. It's a mini coup d'etat, but it goes right along with the idea that they, liberals, should have won the election. They are trying to prove the administration is illegitimate. Now Trump has finally had enough of Obama's treason, and is launching a spy network in order to combat Obama's spies who keep managing to infiltrate him. He's now looking to hire Blackwater founder Eric Prince and John R. McGuire, who will then provide CIA Director Mike Pompeo and the White House with a global, private spy network that would go around the U.S.'s official swamp-infested intelligence agencies, the Gateway pundit reported. This would be a huge blow to Obama's shadow government, as Trump's own private spy network would be able to circumvent the FBI and CIA, both agencies that have become corrupt and politicized under Obama with the appointment of ardently anti-Trump judges and directors. This would allow Trump to oust these infiltrators without the interference of any crooked members of these agencies working to bring him down. It's absolutely insane how Obama is still managing to destroy our country through the minions he's implanted all throughout Washington, D.C. while meeting with foreign diplomats to undermine our president. Working with foreign governments to overthrow the president of the untied states, as Obama is actively doing, is a serious federal crime as spelled out in 18 U.S. Code 2385 that could land him 20 years in behind bars. Working with foreign governments is additionally a violation of the Logan Act, as citizens are prohibited from negotiating with foreign governments in order to undermine our government. Subversion of a sitting president, as in the case with General McMaster's antics, is very serious federal crime, and now that he's been ousted as an Obama operative, it won't be long before he pays dearly for his crimes, as information about his and Obama's treasonous scandal over the past months continues to come to light.